how he used his authority and his position and his status to uplift Allah's deen and to spread the deen of Allah and to bring justice to people. So these are key qualities amongst others inculcated in this chapter that will protect us throughout all trying and challenging times. So let us recite this chapter daily and strive to understand the beautiful meanings of this chapter of the Quran Kareem. Allah give us tawfiq. So Tamim radiyallahu anhu comes from the Lakhm tribe, a Lakhmi. This tribe is known as Lakhm. They were a Qahtani tribe. When this tribe had left and migrated from Yemen after the famous flood called Sad Ma'rib, Quran Sharif refers to this incident under the topic of appreciation in Surah under the discussion of Surah Saba. Allah Ta'ala make us from His appreciative servants. Really, ingratitude is the worst thing. Allah enable us to appreciate Allah's countless bounties. And among the bounties of Allah Ta'ala is the ability to worship Allah openly and have the masajid and so forth. The trying times we have is something for us to sit back and think and introspect that so many of the bounties of Allah, especially practicing Allah's deen openly and so easily, when we have been ungrateful to this, Allah Ta'ala makes us realize this bounty and enable and teaches us this lesson so that we can appreciate. This tribe is known as Bait Lakhm. Lakhm, the Lakhm tribe. Then they moved to other areas. Some moved to different areas. His people, Tamim radiallahu anhu's people, moved to an area in Palestine. So it was known as Bait Lakhm. But then it was transformed, the word was then pronounced Bait Lakhm. But actually they are Lakhmiyin. Anyway, they used to live next to Roman people and then they became Christians. And after that, Tamim radiallahu anhu studied Christianity. He became the rabbi of his people and he started searching for the truth. On one occasion, he says, I went to one area and I was scared on this journey. So I did what the Arabs would do, because he is Arab, where al-isti'adha bil jinn. They would ask the protection of the jinn against any harms in that area. So he said to him, he read this prayer, I'm seeking the protection of the jinn, Allah Ta'ala save us. And when he said this, he heard a voice from the unseen addressing him. Udh billah ayyuhar rajul wastajir bihi. Seek Allah's protection, O man. Seek Allah's protection. Jinn cannot help you, protect you, assist you against Allah. فَإِنَّ الْجِنْ لَا تُجِيرُ أَحَدًا عَلَى اللَّهِ. So I said to this voice, for Allah's sake, I ask you, أَتَقُولُ الْحَقِّ. Are you speaking the truth to me? He said, yes, yes. قَدْ خَرَجَ رَسُولُ الْأُمِّيِّينَ. The final Nabi of Allah has come and we have become Muslim and we followed him. This jinn is telling the Sahabi radiallahu anhu. And jinn cannot do. And the jinn are creation. Turn to Allah. Go to Rasul Rabbil Alameen, the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa aslim, and surrender and become Muslim. Tamim radiallahu anhu says, these words of this jinn touched me. That entire night I spent thinking, pondering, atadabbar. And I started remembering what I studied in the Injil and the Torah about the final Nabi of Allah. Then that morning I rushed to this church. I would go to Deir Ayyub, it was known as. And there was a very, very senior rabbi there who was experienced and I trusted him. I narrated my incident to him and I asked him. He said to me, Sadaqa kal hatif. That voice was speaking the truth. This is about the final Nabi of Allah who has come in Makkah Mukarrama. And he is the best of all Allah's creation, the final of the Anbiya alayhi musallam. Rush to him. وَلَا يَسْبِقَنَّكَ أَحَدٌ إِلَيْهِ إِنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ. Tamim, rush and hasten. Don't let anyone supersede you to him. He said, I called my brother Hind. And we started undertaking this journey from Bait Lakhm towards Medina Munawwara. And when they finally arrived there, they greeted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so happy to welcome them and so happy to hear from them. And that's when Tamim radiallahu anhu narrated to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that amazing event which we will come to. The narrator of that hadith is Fatima bint al-Qais radiallahu ta'ala anha, an amazing sahabiyah who narrated this from the early muhajirat. She narrates that event. But anyway, when he narrated this to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam welcomed them and asked them where they came from and so forth and so forth. In the discussion with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Tamim radiallahu anhu said, O Nabi of Allah, in my vicinity, there's two small communities. There's two communities there. These towns are known as Habra and Ainun. O Nabi of Allah, you are Allah's final Nabi. You have come with the truth. When Allah gives you the lands of Sham, would you give those two vicinities to me? Fahab huma li. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Tamim, huma lak. Those two towns I gift to you. And Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed that this must be documented. So the title deeds were given to Tamim radiallahu anhu. And in this it is inscribed, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Hada kitabun min Muhammadin Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, li Tamim ibn Aws al-Dari. This is a letter from Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for Tamim bin Aws al-Dari radiyallahu anhu, that the vicinity, the town, the qarya Habra and Bayt Aynun is gifted to him. Those two vicinities, the town, the lowlands, the highlands, the mountains, the waters, the plantations, the crop, the flock, everything there belongs to Tamim radiyallahu anhu wa li'aqibihi min ba'dihi, and his offspring after him forever. No one can usurp it from him, take it from him, and or steal it. No one. And whoever does that upon such an individual would be Allah's curse and the malaikas and all the people. And who wrote down this title deed on behalf of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? It was Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Then during the reign of Umar radiyallahu anhu, when these lands of Sham and then specifically Palestine was conquered, and the message came to Amir al-Mu'mineen in Medina Munawwara, Umar radiallahu anhu, I undertook this journey and came to Palestine, came to Palestine, came to Baytul Maqdis. And in that, Tamim al-Dari radiallahu anhu comes forward and says, Oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, these two vicinities were a gift from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to me. And one Sahabi asked, who's your witness? Umar radiallahu anhu says, I bear testimony that this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's gift to Tamim al-Dari radiallahu anhu and his offspring. Then something else happened later on in history. This was in the 6th century, so 505 approximately, the Hijri. What had happened was, there was a case against Tamim radiallahu anhu's family, that This matter was brought up, that how can these two vicinities be Tamim radiallahu anhu's offspring? It should be given back to the Ummah, because this is not fair. The matter was brought to the Qadi, Abu Hamid Harawi, who was the Qadi at that time, and the Dari family were asked about this. They presented the letter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to them, that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this letter. Then the opposite party said that how could Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give what doesn't belong to him? Na'udhu billah. At that time when the matter was brought to Abu Hamid al-Ghazali rahimahullah, the famous Imam Ghazali rahimahullah, at that time, this was before the French had and the Crusaders had overtaken Palestine. This happened before that. Imam Ghazali rahimahullah said that this Qadi is the kafir, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the entire earth, Allah has shown me the entire earth, and he quoted the hadith, Inna Allah zawali al-ard. Allah Ta'ala folded the entire earth to me, and he explains there that this entire dunya is given to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So yes, he says Allah gave Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam Jannah, what about the dunya? And when Imam Ghazali rahimahullah explained this, this Qadi and the governor were both disgraced, and the properties remained in the family of Tamim al-Dari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. We don't have much time. Allah give us tawfiq. Look at yaqeen. What we also learn from Tamim radiyallahu anhu, he came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the 9th year. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this world, this transitory world, in the 11th year, Rabi'ul Awwal. So the short span of time, he spent his time in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, learning the Qur'an al-Kareem, learning Qur'an, learning Hadith. And he completed the entire Qur'an. Many Sahaba radiyallahu anhum wa hafiz. But amongst the famous Hufaz in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Shaykh Ali bin Muhammad bin Khalil Khazraji rahimahullah presents this poem explaining the hafidhas, the special senior hafidhas in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In these words of poetry, he says, وَحَافِذُ الْقُرْآنِ بِالْغُيُوبِ زَيْدٌ أَبُو زَيْدٍ أَبُو أَيُّوبِ عُثْمَانُ مِنْهُمْ وَتَمِيمٌ الدَّارِ وَبَادَةٌ مُعَادٌ الْأَنصَارِ. He quotes the different hafidhas, special hafidhas in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah Ta'ala make us true hafidha of the Qur'an Kareem. Uthman from them, Tamim al-Dari radiallahu anhu from them. In that short span, he memorized the entire Qur'an Kareem. And the famous hadith, we all know this hadith, Ad-Deen al-Nasiha, الدين النصيحة, the narrator of this hadith is Tamim ibn Aws al Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was so senior in the Quran Kareem and in understanding the deen and in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that in Umar radiallahu anhu's time, Umar radiallahu anhu chose two sahaba to lead the prayer in Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the 20 raka'at taraweeh. Sahaba performed 20 raka'at taraweeh, and the two imams were none other than Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu and Tamim ibn Aws al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Let us take this opportunity, let us improve our Quran, let us improve our recital, let us read more and more of the Quran Kareem, let us prepare, Ramadan is round the corner, let us change our lives, let us introspect, let us create the environment of iman and deen and a'mal in our homes, and let us make every home be a sample of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah give us tawfiq. There's so much to learn about Tamim bin Aws al-Dari radiyallahu anhu. Allah give us tawfiq to continue learning more and more about the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyil ummi bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.